Tommy Edison,
nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, man. Yeah, how you doing?
I saw on Twitter that you were here, and I was like, all right, I have got to meet him.
One of the coolest things about being here at VidCon is getting to meet you guys. I mean, you guys take the time to write comments and just like stuff and everything, but man, to actually get to say hello, that's awesome. It's like I almost get to put a face with a voice, but like a voice with a comment, you know? It's very cool. Who's this? What's your name?
My name's Brent.
And my name's Nathan.
Jenny.
William.
James. My name is David.
Adam.
Jackson Harris.
And I'm Athena.
Hi, Athena.
Nice to meet you.
Lovely to meet you, too.
I've heard a lot about you.
You haven't watched?
No, I haven't. Not yet.
What's wrong with you, Athena?
Okay, you know what? I will watch you. I promise I will watch you as soon as I get in the car.
You know, William's going to... I'm going to stick William on you.
Get an idea of how old people are by their voice?
Not really by the voice. I think it's more about what they have to say.
Oh, okay.
Like, what, do you want me to guess your age?
Yeah, okay, guess my age.
So you're kidding, right? I will put you at an even... Wow. I will say 18.
18? I'm 20.
Ooh, so close.
That was really close.
Nice.
That was good.
Just on the outside. Price is Right rules, I'd probably win. Nice to meet you too, man. Big fan. Is this your first time or no?
No, it is my first time this year.
Oh, look at you.
It's my fourth time overall, but my first time this year. Yeah. This is my first time in the hall today. So.
The one guy I had to meet was Michael from Vsauce because so many people that I've met over the weekend have found me through him.
So what are you filming?
I heard that you were here. Well, we're shooting a couple things for the channel. One is sort of my experience of VidCon through the other four senses, right?
Right, right.
You smell some of that food and stuff, some of that pizza they're cooking, and taste, of course, the food, and the sound and the feel of it, too.
So what's been your favorite sensory experience this weekend?
I think it's gotta be just meeting people, people coming up and just, you know, the joy that they have to come and say hello, what I mean? Just the people's response to the videos and the stuff that we've been doing.
Yeah, and it's stuff people don't always think about, but then they can't stop thinking about it. So the drawing one really blew my mind, because the idea that things appear smaller as they move farther away, does that make a lot of sense to someone who's never seen?
No, I don't even get it.
I mean, you have an orange right up next to your face, you can feel it.
Yep.
When it goes far away, it's still the same size, but it looks...
All you see is a dot.
Yeah, I see a dot. Does that make sense to you, or do you just know that it looks like a dot because that's what people tell you?
No, that's exactly right. I just know it from people talking about it and stuff. But, like, I can't imagine, like, the horizon, that's got to be something, too. This thing that you think you could get to and, like, touch and stuff, and it just, you know.
It's always ahead of you.
It's always ahead of you. You can never get there. So vision's a pretty cool thing. I don't know. I think I'll try it one time. Like I said, if I don't like it, I can just keep my eyes closed.
You just keep your eyes closed. You know, and that's always confused me. How come we can close our eyes and our mouths, but we can't close our ears or our noses?
Wow. That's good, man. That's very good.
I can plug them, you know.
But you'll still hear stuff.
I'll still hear stuff, yeah. But I can't choose just not smell things at the moment.
No?
I guess it didn't matter.
Geez, you are good.
You have so much heart, and I think that comes across very well, and you're extremely likable. And people love you, and for good reason.
Jesus, Christian, thank you very much. You talk like I owe you money.